And welcome back. Bruce Porter joins us now for this week's Dollars and Cents segment. Good to see you again.
Good to be here.
Thanks for coming in. Shoulder doing all right?
Oh, yeah. It's, you know, rehab's coming along, so, it'll
eventually... And you're doing it the right way. You're not pushing it at all.
No, I'm planning on being able to beat you in golf next year.
Okay. You know, last week... We talked about life insurance awareness, and we're still focusing on that, you know, this week as well. So,
yeah,
remind people or let them know what you know, do they need to know? What do they need to be aware of?
Well, this is Life Insurance Awareness Month, so that's why we're kind of focused on information maybe the viewers can use to decide what they need, things like that. So I ran some statistics on the life insurance industry.
Okay.
There's 852 life insurance companies in the U.S., so you got a lot of choices.
Yeah, I would
say. If you want to get a quote from each one, you need to plan for that because it's probably going to take a while. There's $8.3 trillion in assets owned by life insurance companies.
That was with a T, right?
That's trillion? With a T. So that's a huge industry. They take in, because we all pay premiums,
right,
they take in $1.2 trillion per year. Only 60% of life insurance is owned in U.S. households. The average need of life insurance is about $459,000, give or take. But the average owned insurance face amount is about $126,000. So the question always comes up, how do you evaluate what you need and things like that?
Exactly.
So my advice would be to take the time to analyze your family situation and determine what kind of need you might have, and then go from there. We've got some screenshots on some different types of benefits that are available inside life insurance policies.
Yeah.
This first one is long-term care rider.
Okay.
Now, a lot of times that's referred to as a living benefits rider. So if you would happen to go into long-term care,
okay,
and you've still got a life insurance in force that has this rider on it, you're able to access the death benefit for care cost prior to death. Now,
and the truth is, more and more people are going into long-term care than before. We're living longer.
17 times more likely to need care prior to a funeral home. Now, there's usually an extra cost for that, things like that. So you got to be aware of that.
Mm-hmm.
Now, traditional term insurance, the thing you got to understand about term insurance, it's for a specific period of time of coverage.
Right.
And it's usually at a lower cost. But it's the most profitable business for a life insurance company because less than 1% of policies are ever paid out in a death claim.
Well, term is also kind of front-loaded, isn't it?
Well, it depends on what type you buy, and there's several types.
Okay.
So if you, let's say, for example, you bought a level premium term policy for 20 years.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so 20 years down the road, that's going to expire. So if you bought it when you were 35, now you're 55, and your insurance runs out.
Right.
Now, you might reapply and get more, but that's why less than 1% of term insurance is paid in a death claim. People either drop it or don't have it in force when they need it the most.
Okay.
All right? So it's very profitable. Whole life insurance is... the most expensive, you might say, life insurance, but...
There are advantages to that, though.
There's huge advantages.
Right.
Number one, over the years, you build up paid-up insurance, you build up cash values that, honestly, and it gets pretty advanced, but when you look at doing policy loans later in life,
yes,
against your values and your benefit, those policy loans are very tax-favored coming out, and then at death... They're attributed to, they come off the death benefit, and then they're taxable at that point.
Yeah.
But as far as supplemental retirement planning,
right,
life insurance cash values can be accessed for that.
Okay, we're going to have to wrap it up very quickly.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Return of premium policies, the last slide, usually doubles the cost. So you got to be careful, I would sum up, when you're buying life insurance and it's got a lot of extra benefits, be careful, beware of cost, because it can drive your premium up. But buy the basics first. Yeah. You can always advance later on.
Talk to the experts. That's the best way to
best
find
advice.
Out need versus, you know, what you want to have.
That's exactly
and,
right.
And, you know, if you have any financial questions for Bruce, visit his website, resource-center-inc.com, or give him a call at 417-882-1800. Give him a call.
Be glad to help.
I know you would.
You bet.
I'm sure we'll be talking more on insurance.
One more week. See you next week.
Okay, sounds fine. Up next, Hook contestant Jayden Laborde is taking the stage, so don't go anywhere. We'll be back before you know it.